They're not big, but they're keepers.
There we go.
There we go.
Well, this is Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV, and I'm Kevin Ford. That's Captain Lloyd Landry. We have a strong east wind today. We're in Buras, Louisiana, and we're gonna see what we can catch fishing. You know, you don't always get the best days to fish and the best conditions, Lloyd, but down here in Plaquemines Parish, we can catch fish in the wind. And that's what we're gonna show you how to do today. Catch some fish in the wind on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.
There we go, Kev. You want them, bro?
There's another one right off this little island. It's amazing, this island right here. Lloyd, it used to go way back.
It used to go 100 yards out further from here, and there were bushes all on it. But as you feel that jig head, it's all shells on the bottom. And this reef goes out there 100 yards. We're just kind of taking the cover behind this island, so.
A lot of times when you fish a jig, you bounce it off the bottom. And a lot of people think you have to bounce a jig off the bottom to catch fish. But sometimes you can just cast and retrieve a jig just like a swim bait. And that's all I'm doing. I'm not bouncing these things at all. I'm just casting and retrieving real slow. As soon as I start hitting the bottom, I pick up speed a little bit and they've been normally picking it up. In fact, this is the first cast I had when I didn't have a bite. You would think the cork would be the ticket here, Lloyd. I mean, you really would.
Yeah.
I think you'll get a bite.
I think I'm gonna try.
I've had a bite.
Oh, I just missed one.
You did?
Yeah.
I was about to say.
I was gonna ask, look, you got that one.
I got that one.
I was gonna ask you if I could reel one in, but that's a nice one, Kev.
Yeah.
Nice trout. Dude, what did he just spit up?
I don't know.
He just threw up something out of his mouth.
What did he throw up?
I don't know, it went everywhere. It was kind of slimy.
I know. Well, these things are kind of slimy to begin with. It is springtime, so things are warming up, but we're coming off the warmest winter in record here in South Louisiana. So things have been different. I mean, it's like everything's a month ahead instead of a month behind,
right,
like it usually is.
The river's low, you know, unseasonably low already. Whereas last year we were launching in waist deep water. You had to bring waders to launch our boat in the river.
Right.
And now this year it's not. And man,
this is fun now. When you can get out here first spot and start catching them every cast, that's pretty fun. But yeah, it's amazing.
It's also a little scary though.
Yeah, it's amazing how different everything is this year than from what was last year.
Right.
That's not a bad thing.
You have a white head on.
You just need to quit. You need to quit jerking it and just reel it.
I can't let Kevin Ford tell me how to fish. We're about to leave this spot. They're here. All right, we gotta go. I haven't caught any. Kevin's caught six.
I got a bite like three times on that cast. Another pretty good one here, Lloyd. Now, you said when we got to this spot, this is kind of a school trout spot.
Right.
Why is that? What makes it?
Well, we're right here on the edge of the bay. We're right on the edge, right around the corner from California Bay. And right now we have incoming tide. There's just a lot of shells on the bottom, and it seems like Those smaller trout will hang right inside where the current's not so bad,
right,
coming around this corner. And you noticed when we came out of the cut from the river, the water was real dirty. Then once we got around this corner, the water got cleaner, you know. And with that incoming tide, the water is going to get a little cleaner as it comes up.
Well, just a simple cast and retrieve, which is not the norm, but it's not broke.
When you
don't
do
it.
That, it actually makes it easier on a lot of customers.
Yeah,
we got a double.
Yeah. Makes it easier on
the guys too.
Yeah,
now,
makes it easier on us.
I'm gonna let mine go since he's undersized. And yours is a keeper. Thank goodness, because we just dumped both of them on the floor. We're probably not even going to put that on TV.
Oh, no, that's on TV because I just kicked that one out. Yeah,
that was a keeper.
Yeah, I know. Well, I didn't do it on purpose.
That's one less pull board for us now.
I know. I mean, these things are hitting right on the side of the boat. It's almost like you can cast right there instead of out. It's like they're following the bait in. And what I'm fishing with is a 3/8 ounce Rockport rattle or jig head and a lemon head matrix shad. Now, we're in this real shallow water, and you're like, well, why are you fishing with such a heavy jig head? Well, pretty simple. It's easier to cast into the wind. We're not bouncing it off the bottom, and there's nothing that this thing's gonna get hooked on. So it's a little bit heavier, and it's just easier to cast and retrieve. So that's why I'm doing a 3/8 ounce jig head in 2 feet of water.
Ooh, ooh. There he goes. I saw that rod thump.
You saw it?
Yeah.
That one was a little thought out. Yeah, that was a...
He was aggressive. He knocked the heck out of it.
He did knock the heck out of it. Yeah, just... Oh, you got one too, huh?
Yeah. I'm catching the small ones, keeping them out the way for you.
You keeping them out the way?
Yeah.
That's what a good guy does.
It's okay, I'm keeping count. When you get to 25, you're done.
I'm done?
No. Well, no.
No. That's about to say.
I was hoping.
Yeah.
It's a good sign, though. We're catching a lot of throwbacks. So,
yeah.
You know, here it is, right at the end of March.
Uh-oh.
Oh, there's your bull red.
Oh, he got off.
He ate your trout?
Yeah.
Did he really get off?
No.
Did he get off? No, he came at us.
He came at us. I was just about to say.
Uh-oh.
Whoa, yikes. Man, all right, enough is enough.
I'm gonna keep catching trout while Kevin plays with these bull reds.
Yeah. Hey, this is what people come down here to fish for.
Oh, there's no doubt. And we have the best of both worlds.
Yeah.
And look, it is windy.
But the sun is barely over the horizon. Come on in, buddy. I promise you we're gonna let you get. Promise. Boy, it is kind of fun when you can go to a spot and catch speckled trout and bull reds. And this is a typical Buras bull red right here.
That he is. I mean
he ain't.
We honestly haven't gone far from the river. We're right across from the water tower. And he's not being cooperative to be on television, but.
All right, there we go. All right.
And if you notice, this is why my net is beat up, because big bull red's head liked to plow through your net like this one just did. God, doggy, he ripped it.
And these bull reds, they will eat our speckled trout, won't they?
Yes. All right, let's move this out the way.
But yeah, that's...
Dude, he smoked your jig. He smoked everything.
Yeah, I am smoked. I got a retie.
You want to pick with him? You want to hold him, or you want me to?
You can hold him for a second, and then we can take a picture in a minute. But yeah, that's a nice bull. We're gonna release him. You can keep those. You can keep one per person over 27. Really, no reason to do it. So
no, these
we're
aren't.
Gonna take a picture. What is it? CPR: catch, photo, release.
Yes, yeah. Sir.
We don't do that with speckled trout. 13-inch speckled trout, you can't. 13, 14-inch speckled trout, you can't do that. You know that, right?
Yep.
You have to release those in the ice chest.
Yes.
All right, we're gonna take us a nice picture and commence to catching more fish. How the Pros Do It is brought to you by Demco, your Touchstone Energy Cooperative.
One thing I typically do when I start out in the morning at a particular spot, every day the water clarity is different. So what I do like to do with clients is, especially if we're throwing all plastic, I'll put a different color on everyone's pole. And 9 times out of 10, one color dominates over the other. So, you know, a lot of times I might have the chartreuse on, or, you know, a guy has a black and chartreuse or the white and chartreuse. I just kind of mix it up and we see who starts doing better. And then we'll just change everybody's bait over. So always try early multiple colors, and also try multiple depths on your cork. The fish aren't always holding at 14 inches or 16 inches. That's gonna vary also. It also will vary where you're casting, the depth of the water. So try those couple things and may help you put more trout in the box. Yeah.
Got him, bud?
Yeah.
Ooh, nice. Just a simple cast and retrieve, huh?
Yep, nothing fancy.
Oh, wow, that one hit the water, how about that? Oh, and I got a nicer one, buddy. How much fun are we having today? Fishing soft plastics, and look at that. Pretty good, huh? That's even better. Come fishing with Lloyd, he'll take your fish off. We didn't get up, we didn't get out here till a little bit after the sun came up. It's been a relaxing morning. Fish aren't really feeding on shrimp yet, are they? I mean, there may be some left over, but it's a little bit early, isn't it?
Well, it is a little early, but I'm going to tell you, last week, 2 days in a row, we left the west side heading towards Four Bayous and caught a P-load of speckled trout under birds on shrimp.
Oh, wow.
Now, little bitty shrimp, but a lot of little bitty trout. But it's a good sign because that's things we haven't been seeing in a couple years. So I'm very happy and excited about what the spring looks like it's going to be.
And we're catching exactly the size fish that we figured we'd catch where we are right now.
Right.
Which is what we're doing.
In years past, we've fished the west side this time of the year and caught bigger ones. And I've been catching some bigger ones over there. But with this east wind, southeast, that's a better one. The southeast wind blowing the way it is today, you don't have any more protection. So, you know.
Yeah, this is, you take what's given to you, and believe me, when we got in the Buras today and saw that American flag, you could see all 50 stars on it sticking straight out. So this is one of those days where, you know, you hope to catch 10 or 15 fish, and, you know, we've done that already, so it's been great. I wonder, you know what, I sit here and think that you get a bite every cast, and then four casts, you know, this, what's going on down there? I mean, there's got to be something that...
That big bull red that you caught, his sister or brother came swimming through here and they went... Pew.
I mean, that's got to be it, isn't
yeah.
it? I mean, you go every cast with getting the... And then now what? This is four or five casts that we've gone and...
I sped it up. I slow it down. I'm bouncing on the bottom.
Oh, there he is. There he is.
They see what it is. We're sitting right on the edge of that current line. And I just kind of think those fish are just moving in and out of here. Oh, there you go. A little bit better one. You notice my boat's turned a little bit.
Yeah. We could tell an interesting story. About 3 or 4 weeks ago, we were on a point right over there and we took our girls fishing. We weren't shooting a show or anything. And we were fishing for redfish and it was another windy day and we didn't catch anything. So we're crossing this bay. And Lloyd and I look out and we both say, boy, that's a nice current line.
Yeah, and we're talking 100 yards off this point.
Just a beautiful current line. And we said, we both make the call, that's a nice current line. So we go, struggle all day, catch a few fish, find out one of his friends is fishing, and he goes, oh yeah, there was a big current line not far where y'all went, and we caught 100 trout.
Yeah, pulled up and caught 100 trout.
I mean, right in the middle, yeah, see, if it looks good, stop and fish it.
Sure. Oh, what was that?
What was that?
That was a mermaid.
Mermaid fishing's been good out here too, hasn't it?
She said they're over there.
You got one?
Yep, further out off the point.
Yeah, that's where mine was just now.
Well, look what we're looking at. What are we looking at? A current line.
A current line. Never pass up a good current line.
Yeah. That's my...
Tip of the day.
Tip of 2017.
Oh, especially when you have your kids in the
boat. Yeah, when you have your kids in the boat.
Boy, how many times is he going to hit that bait?
I don't know. You want to watch your cork for you?
What? Did you see how many times he hit it? Watch. I'll do it again.
When it goes down, you set the hook. Did something just pop on it? Or did it jump? Oh, is that a mullet jump out the water?
That's a mullet just jumped right there.
Okay. There you go.
Nope.
Holy smokes. I'm going to put a whistle on that thing. Or a shocker. As we sit here and fish, there's a pipe. There's a PVC pipe out there. That when I first started guiding, I mean, this is 1994. This land was out there by that pipe. And there was a big pipeline sign out there. And God, we used to catch a lot of, we still do catch a lot of fish. I say that all the time, but it's amazing how, I wish we could put some of these islands back.
Oh!
Yeah, they're still biting.
I'm coming.
She was getting a drink.
I was getting me a little drink.
Ooh, look at this monster.
There you go. Did somebody take a shot at him?
Yeah. He got a whack on his back. Something tried to eat him. He's good though. He's healthy. I'll put some ice on his bubble. Little male trout, little skinny. Kev, we got dinner, baby.
Yeah, there's a lot of people that try to, we try to eat those, but guess what? There's other things out there to try to eat them too.
Well, we're fortunate that we're at the top of the food chain.
I missed one.
There you go.
I didn't miss
there
that one.
There you go.
Didn't miss him.
No, I can't believe you went.
You know what? We were talking a few minutes ago about the Mississippi River and how close we are to the river down here. And everything down in this area, the reason why it's so good is because of the Mississippi River and the nutrients and all that kind of good stuff that we have. And if you want to realize how close we are to the river, if you look over there, you can see a ship. There's two, looks like two goalposts and the ship behind it. That's the Mississippi River. So, I mean, we're close to this river where we are right now.
Oh yeah, we're a mile from it. But, you know, all the time two people think because we have that Mississippi River water, we can't catch trout.
Right.
But we're so close, that water comes out the river and it doesn't mix yet. So most of the time, the water might be dirty on top, but it's cleaner underneath, especially with the incoming tide, so you have clean seawater. Now, further you go out in the Breton Sound, the water will be mixing and get dirtier. Right. But right here, I can't tell you how many times we've been fishing these cuts and the water's dirty and you pull up and customers go, what are we doing? And then you hit your trolling motor or your big motor and you see that green water underneath. You know, that's those trout are right here on right up along the river.
And you can't see it, but about, I guess a half mile that way is the pure river water. So, I mean, we're just out of it by about a half mile or so,
yeah.
But don't want to scare you away. This is a good thing. All the nutrients, all the bait is because of that river right there, and it's good.
And I mean, we're whacking them this morning on plastic. And, you know, something that I've talked to a buddy of mine that's over in Cocodrie and stuff right now. We have live shrimp. So it's kind of a double-edged sword for the captains, because you have to mess with that live bait, but it also makes it easier on clients.
It does. And the other thing that we can show people here, Lloyd, is there's the island behind us by about 15 yards. Look where we're casting. And we're casting way away. And it's like
right.
You said, the structure is still on the bottom. So just don't think you have to be fishing right next to these islands, because if you do, you're going to cost yourself a lot of fish.
Right, and I tell people all the time, when you're coming up to an island, existing piece of marsh that's left, start 50, 60, 80 yards off, put your trolling motor down, and ease in. And once you catch a fish, put your power pole down, and you hear the shells.
Right.
And then you realize that, you know, those fish are out there for a reason. There's structure on the bottom holding them.
Oh, that one right there. Well, Lloyd, this has been pretty good this morning, buddy.
It
is. I mean, it's been, I got a jumper out there. We've caught fish almost one after the other. I know it's not 8:30 in the morning yet, and we're done. Come on down. It's going to be a great year here in Plaquemines Parish in Buras, Louisiana. Captain Lloyd Landry with Outcast Fishing Charters can put you on some good fish, speckled trout, redfish, whatever you want. This is the guy that can do it right here. And Lloyd, great morning, man.
Thanks, buddy. Quick and easy.
I'm glad we decided to come today than next Monday.
Right, but watch, it'll be calm next Monday.
No, it won't be calm next Monday. Hey, thanks for watching the show, everyone. And for producer Joey Bordelon and Captain Lloyd Landry, I'm Kevin Ford. We'll see you next time right here on Louisiana Outdoor Adventures TV.